Let's make education smarter, and we will get to that in a while. But let me, this is what I mean. When I say let's make education smarter, what I'm trying to say is let's make it specialized for each learner. Let's make it motivational, so everybody wants to learn. Let's make it achievable for each learner's based on their skill set and requirement. Let's make it revisionary. Let's keep changing it rather than getting stuck to a level. And let's do it together. Teachers, families, especially students, everybody together. That's why I said let's make it smarter. Many children struggle in schools because the way they are being taught is not compatible with the way they learn. This is a quote by Peter Senge, who is an American system scientist. He is a senior lecturer at MIT Sloan Institute School of Management, and he is the founder of the Society for Organizational Learning. And I particularly like this quote because I have to give you some examples from my life, some people that I've met, and my own experiences in my childhood as a student. First, I want to talk to you about a girl who is 6 years old. She is my daughter, my friend's daughter. This child struggles with autism. So when she was 2 years old, the doctors diagnosed that she lacks communication skills, not just verbal, even non-verbal. So what you and I, we can communicate through our expressions and gestures, she cannot do. My friend tried putting her in different schools, but everybody basically said, no, we're sorry, your daughter cannot learn. Thankfully, my friend believed in her daughter, so she tried various methods possible. Today, this kid is 6 years old, and she can solve maths problems that a 14-year-old solves in India. Okay? So what does that tell us? It basically tells us that the others were not able to figure out what her learning needs are and how she had to be taught. Coming to my experience, I was put in an Indian school when I was 5 years old. And after 1 month of schooling, the teacher called my parents for a very serious meeting. And she said, I have to tell you, though your daughter is the tallest in our class, she is quite dumb. That's the word she used, she was quite dumb. Every other kid is able to solve any problem I give them. She's not able to do that. So when I heard this story from my mother later, it was very interesting to me. First, how is my height related to my intelligence level? I don't know. Secondly, she wrote me off as dumb, but I'm still here, aren't I? I work, I earn, I study more. So that was one experience. Then when I was 12 years old, my parents moved to Ukraine for work. I studied in an American international school for 2 years. There, within the first week, the teachers assessed my knowledge level. They understood that my requirement was a little different from my classmates. So they came up with lesson plans that worked for me. It would have been convenient for them to just put me in together with the rest and say, you know what, you do what everybody else is doing. But they didn't want to do that. So they came up with something different that worked for me. I studied in Moscow for 7 months in an Indian school. The teachers there again, they put an additional effort to understand my needs, and they prioritized that over their convenience. Cut back to India. I returned to India after 2.5 years. I'm put back in the old educational system, where if I tried to be different, not just my classmates, but my teachers also mocked me. I was bullied also. I had to fit into an educational system that has been working since the 1920s, and it hasn't really changed much in all these years. I had to learn subjects that I had no interest in, and I was forced, I was expected to score equally in all the subjects. Otherwise, I fail, and then I don't go to college, and I don't come here, right? So these are some of the experiences I've had as a student. Now, if you think about it, let's just ask ourselves, how is our education system treating us today? Is it actually preparing us for the life ahead? Do we actually use what we learn in school in our life ahead? I don't think I do, except maybe English, yeah, I use that a lot. Otherwise, no, not really. Everything that I've had to do today, I've learned from my mistakes and I've tried again, and then that's how I've learned it. And that's what brings me to my points here. What do I want? I think we should do away with exams. No more competition. I like the idea that Singapore has done this. And I think others should also follow suit. It's high time we stop competition in learning. Learning should be for learning's sake, because we want to use it somewhere, we are curious about something, and that curiosity word is very important too. I believe that in every school, there should be certified counselors who have learned a little bit of child psychology too, and they work in sync with parents, with the student, with the teacher, and come up with individualized learning plan that works for individuals, not for an entire class. We need to keep evaluating and re-evaluating our current methods. Just because it worked in 1920s, 1930s, whenever, doesn't mean it's going to work now. Even if it worked 6 months back, it worked for me, not necessarily it's going to work for all of you. So for each one of us, our learning plan should be different. We need to encourage a learning environment where it's okay to fail. It's okay. You try something, it doesn't work, it's okay. Everybody should be brave and they should be allowed to try again and again till they find their own way. We need to include a culture of inclusion where students like my friend's daughter, they also can come to the same school, they get exposed to the same environment, but because their learning needs are different, they are taught differently. And we need to see education as an investment into the future of every individual, of the country they are from, and of our society in general. I just want to end with this quote. Everyone is a genius, but if you judge a fish on its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing it is stupid. And that's Albert Einstein for you. Thank you.